It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
It is indeed your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Expresso at SABC3. And when it comes to music, we got it for you this morning. I think we all need it right now. And, you know, visual albums have seen an increase in popularity over the past couple of years. I'm sure you've seen them all over the social media sites. And these albums are more than just videos. They tell a story through the lyrics and the art and the music. I think it's so beautiful. And South African multi-instrumentalist, producer, music teacher, part-time lecturer. I'm sure there are three other things I should have mentioned from the University of Cape Town. His name is Blake Hellaby, and he recently released his visual album, Another Perspective. And this morning, Blake joins us to tell us a bit more about his visual album before taking to the floor to perform three songs for you from the album. Blake, welcome, my friend.
Thanks for having me.
I was speaking to Carl earlier on, and I was trying to give a story of how I met you. So your wife actually direct messaged me a couple of weeks ago, and she was like, my husband's amazing, you should hear him out. And I'm like, okay, cool. Like, everyone, if everyone's going to message me that the husband is amazing, we're going to have a full-on show. And she sent me a link, and she's like, listen to it, and you'll understand. I opened the link, and I was like, whoa. South Africa needs to hear you. South Africa needs to see what you do, because you have such an interesting musical journey. And maybe you can share that with us this morning.
Yeah, so I come from a classically trained background. I learned classical piano from the age of 8. And I went on to do all my classical stuff, and I wasn't that interested. And then I discovered jazz eventually when I went to high school. I went to Sykes High, and they forced me into jazz. And then I was like, wow, this is this is pretty cool. Like, you know, and I started falling in love more and more, and I couldn't find myself getting myself away from the piano. I was just, you know, at first it was more sport orientated, but then I went into jazz, and I never turned back. I went to study jazz against my whole family's wishes, and I love it. So I went on to study jazz, and then from there I discovered a whole lot of other, a whole world of music, of pop and stuff, which I wasn't exposed to much as a kid. And it's been a really amazing journey finding myself in this. I still am.
You can tell there's a lot of passion from you. And when somebody says a multi-instrumentalist, it's so difficult. You know when they say you're a jack of all trades and a master of none sometimes?
Yeah,
How difficult was it to kind of say, okay, piano's first, and now let's pick up all these other things and still obviously have that, you know, musician's obsession with making sure that everything that you play is perfect?
Well, yeah, I've kind of given up on a lot. Not forever, but it's kind of like, you know, you get good at something and you think you're good, and then you get better and you realize you're not good at all. And I kind of got to that, and I realized I still need to learn to play the piano better before I pick up these other ones properly, you know. So it's really good having learned. I learned saxophone at high school, and I did bass at university. And understanding those instruments has really helped my production, whether it be pop or jazz production, arrangement, or something like that. That's been amazing. But, yeah, piano's a lot.
But can you play the triangle, though? Because maybe you can give us some inspiration on how to play
that. I kid you not. We are doing, the three of us, and I'm producing an album with a Brazilian artist. And, you know, even in South Africa, we have a percussionist playing, and he's like, you're not playing the triangle right. And he's a percussionist.
There's a way to
yeah,
play it?
Yeah, he's like, no, you have to drop your hand and all. I'm like, you do that.
What?
Cool.
I thought it was just like a cowbell.
No, it's like in Brazil, and those South American, it's like, there's a plate. You know, someone plays a plate. A real plate and a knife. And that's on the album. I had to record him. I'd like, how do I mic up a plate?
that does make sense, because on a Sunday lunch, usually, that's what I do.
I was saying, you know, you don't want those people at your Sunday lunch. Yeah. They look like, do you like this plate? You know? Sounds great.
So I just want to ask you about Another Perspective, because now you've got all of these collective influences, and now you've put this thing together, which is a visual album.
Yeah.
Tell me a bit more about how you've come to a visual album, because I think that, you know, it's quite a bold move for anybody. And more importantly, how does anybody go grab that and go check it out?
Well, first and foremost, it's on the National Arts Festival page.
Nice.
You can just Google it, Another Perspective, Blake Hellaby, and you'll find it.
I'm a musician by
basically, in lockdown, everyone was doing live streaming. You know, all the musicians didn't know how to get the creativity, and not only because we needed to make money, but because for most of us, it is what we do. Like, we have to let out our soul. You know, we have to do it, whether it's good or not. And so my manager wanted me to do a live stream, and he was like investing in all his equipment. And as time went by, I was realizing it's getting boring. Like, it's not the same. Most people, you can't connect the audience in a live stream. It's a different perspective.
There it is.
So I had to do that. Yeah. So, and then I realized, like, I started writing for it. I started writing some music because, you know, in lockdown, we were given time, and some people used it productively and some didn't, and I decided to use it productively. And I started like seeing things and noticing stuff when I was reading, and problems in society, and what we could gain from it and what we've lost from it. Eventually, when it came around to us kind of getting around to actually doing it, I realized like a live stream wouldn't do this justice, you know. Mm. And I then penned the idea of the story of how each song fitted in together. And I sat with the director, Paolo Costa, and he videoed everything and put it together painstakingly for hours and hours and days, putting the whole story together. And making something of it into something more than just a performance. So it's not something you can experience on stage, and it's not something you can experience on a live on a live stream. It's a mixture of everything. So it's a story with visuals, with me narrating over it a bit, and us playing in studio live.
I want to hear this live.
I'm excited that everybody else gets to experience what I got to experience virtually, but now we are doing it right here.
Okay, can you just play something for us, if you don't mind? I know that you got your crew here. I'm not sure what their names are. I think it's like Dane Paris and Sean Sandby and Zeke LaGrange.
I don't know them, but
But I'd love to hear Circumstances, which is cool. The one that I actually picked up on when I stalked you last night before this interview. So if you don't mind humoring us with some amazing jams. Okay, cool. Let's get the chairs out the way like we do at the yard parties. Let's go.